We are here at the Rebuild Develop. I'm the technical artist of Weaving Tides. Weaving Tides is like a flow adventure game where the whole world is made of strings and you can stitch through them. And you play as a little boy who meets his dad, which is called a weaver. And the weaver raised him, and together you can explore the world and find out where the other humans went.
So this game, it's like an open world game where you're like sewing together the world?
Yeah, it's something like that, because you are just thrown into a world that is ripped apart, and with your ability you can mend the world, you can help the people, and you can explore it, and maybe you'll find out the secrets behind it.
So where did the idea for this game come from?
The original idea comes from our front woman. She is also the creative director, and she makes awesome concept art. And she had the idea of a world that is completely woven, made of cloth. And she thinks a lot about what abilities could you have in such a world to survive.
I see a lot of, I look at it and I think a lot of that Yarn Yoshi game that Nintendo released a year ago.
Yeah, that's definitely one inspiration. We really, really like Nintendo games, and they are very juicy and polished, so we definitely look at them. But I think our other main inspiration is, of course, Bastion. Bastion is also one of the best isometric games that we played, and we really love it. We love the music and the feeling, and yeah, that is really one of our goals, to go in that direction.
Can you talk about what it's been like working with Unity and what they provided your team in terms of tech and support to help make the game a reality?
I really like to work with Unity because I can use Playmaker, and for me as a tech artist, I can prototype very fast, and also I have some JavaScript experience, so I can also use that knowledge for Unity. And we like the versioning so that we can work together. We are a small team, it's only 4 developers, so it's really nice for us, I think, yeah.
As a technical artist, what are some of the challenges when you can interact with the entire world map?
Yeah, so one of the challenges is that everything has to feel alive. So we put a lot of effort in the woven ground, for example, and also the court that is like the border of the world has to be procedural, because the shape of the levels vary from level to level. So there are a lot of technical challenges for me as well.
So when does your game come out? What platforms will it be on?
We are aiming to release the game in 1.5 years from now away. And a platform we are targeting mostly computer, but also one console. And that's why we are at a Reboot, to make connections and to get the best deal to decide on which console to release, yeah.
Any plans for Nintendo Switch?
Yeah, of course, because we love Nintendo games, but we are open for all consoles.